How are you?
I'm very well. What about you?
I'm very well, thank you. My name is Shanna. What's your name?
Oh, it's nice to meet you, Shana. I'm Richard, and I'm calling you from Brazil.
No way.
Yeah. And what
Welcome.
about you?
I am from Canada.
That's cool. That's really cool.
Have you ever been to Canada?
No, I haven't, but I would love to go there.
Yes.
To Vancouver, to
Ah.
what is the other place? Yeah, there are so many places I'd love to go there. I study English and also Spanish. Oh, thank you.
Great.
I study English and Spanish, so yeah, I think I'm gonna be always a student.
Yes, you know what? That's very smart because there the life is for living and learning, and the more we learn, knowledge is power, right?
Yes, exactly. And I can't imagine having a life without learning, being studying, because as you said, it's really interesting to know a lot of things. We can it's so interesting. I love learning. I think it's so great, to especially in English, in other languages, because we get to know so many great people, and yeah, it intrigues me. I feel so impressed by that. So I love studying languages and a lot of things.
Yes, and was that what else do you plan to study? Just different languages?
I plan on applying for my master's degree
Okay.
in technology or in computer programming. I'm thinking about that. I'm still thinking about that. And I intend to go to another country, to be part of an exchange program, be able to be part of what is it called? I think it's called family program. I don't know what it's called.
Okay.
But when you apply for being at a person's home and
Oh,
you
cool. So
get to speak with them every
like
day,
an
so you can
exchange?
study. It's like an exchange. Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly. So it'll be cool because I think it's better to be able to experience the everyday in life, because sometimes, even though I get to talk to people here on Cambly and it's really awesome, but I think during the day we come across so many things, so I think being able to experience that, I will be able to use words to see things that I usually don't have the opportunity here on Cambly. You know what I mean?
Yes, exactly. It's all about experiencing, right? I
Yeah,
could say I'm from Canada.
it's all
I
about
could
it.
tell you about the snow, but then it's
Yeah.
being here, right? And getting a snowball in your face.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah, that's exactly what I mean.
Wait. But Richard, you don't want a snowball in your face. No.
No, I don't want it. I don't want it. But just play around,
Yeah.
go to a lot of places, see things together. Yeah. It's so different. Go camping. Go skiing and
Skiing,
skiing, skiing or
skiing,
skiing, yeah. Go skiing, yeah.
skiing,
Go
yeah.
skiing.
Go, well, there's two types of skiing, right? Which one would you like to try? Downhill or cross country? Cross country is more like flat.
No, I prefer downhill. I'm
Downhill,
a red hot
right?
person. Yeah, I'm an active person.
Yeah, you would like it. So the best times for that in Canada is, yeah, January, February, March, and then there's something called spring skiing, which there's still a lot of snow, but it's warmer, and usually people ski with no jacket, just like a turtle. You would love it.
Oh yes,
Yeah.
I would for
Yeah.
sure, especially because I don't like cold days. I prefer I'm used to hot days, as you can see my clothes. I'm wearing a tank top, so
Yes. Where are you from again, Richard?
I'm from Brazil. I live in São Paulo. I live on the coast.
Okay.
Do you know where São Paulo
Yes,
is?
yes, yes.
Yeah, so I live on the coast of the state of São Paulo, so my city is really hot. It's mostly hot, and we usually go to the beach. We play outside. We go for a run, go for a walk. So
Now,
yeah,
what about
it's pretty.
now during the pandemic? Can you do all of those things?
Okay, so yes, we were in lockdown for a couple of months, for 2 months,
Yeah.
I think. But right now, we can go to the beach, you know, to go for a walk.
Is
So, but
are they
we
limiting?
can't swim.
Yeah, are they
Yeah,
limiting?
they are limiting. Yeah, they are limiting, you know, people, you know, but we can't swim. We just can go on the beach, sometimes play a little bit soccer or a sport, you know, to work out, to go for a run, to go for a walk. I think from 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. we have this range. Do you know what I mean?
So, yes, I understand. What I don't understand, so if someone could go to the beach, why can't they let you swim?
I don't know either.
Maybe it's because that might attract more people.
Yeah, probably, especially because my city, there are so many tourists here. So a lot of people come from other cities. So if they let people to
Yeah.
swim, it's gonna be out of control.
It's true, right? Imagine how can you control? Okay, only two in the water, and excuse me, hello. It would be impossible, right?
Exactly. That's so funny. And what do you think? A lot of people say, oh, it's important to the government, you know, the government says, oh, stay at home and you can't go to the beach, you can't go outside. Because but there are a lot of people who say, oh, I think they are limiting our freedom. What do you think about this subject?
Yeah, they certainly are limiting our freedom, but I think they're doing it for a reason, unfortunately. Right?
Yeah, exactly. Because imagine if we didn't have any, you know, limitations, people would go around and would get the
Yes.
disease, right? So
Yes.
it'll be out of
You
control,
know
right?
what, Richard? I know a lot of people, I'm myself included. I would love to. This is our summers, right? I would love to be out. They canceled every single festival, the Jazz Fest, the Film Fest, the Grand Prix, which is racing. They canceled everything, right? I would love to go, but we can't do it, you know, for now.
Yeah, especially because this disease, coronavirus, is so contagious. So I think if it wouldn't, I think everything would be normal, but as it's contagious, we have to be careful because we can infect other people,
Well,
especially the elderly people. They
did a
are
lot
in the
of
danger.
elderly die in where you are in Brazil?
Yeah.
Yeah,
Yeah,
that's
they
true.
are. And I think you know that Brazil is the second country, you
Is it
know,
right now
with
second? It's
much.
still?
Yeah, it's right now. United States is the first
Of
one,
course.
Brazil is the second.
Of course. You didn't have to
Yeah.
tell me the first one, okay, Richard? Yeah, I know. Look
Yeah.
who their leader is, right?
Yeah, but I was already expecting that, you know, the United States to be the first one. Because a lot of people go there. There's no way out.
And they're having their parties. They had their big, July 4th, right? Independence Day. I'm sure, even though they said on the news, you know, no part, they had parties like crazy.
Yeah, and they're having protests right now, and which is great, but I think it helps the pandemic to spread out, right?
Yeah, exactly. That's what they're doing every time they're protesting, right? What does protest mean? It means big groups and close.
Together, yeah.
What can we do, right, Richard?
Yeah, exactly. But yeah, and what about in Canada? So is everything normal now? What is it
No,
like right
like you
now?
say, it's still social distancing. Restaurants, we see restaurants, they put up the partition. It's so weird. You feel like you're almost in futuristic. You know, like just two people, like, you and I and our partitions, and then the next one, and the people, the servers are wearing visors. So it looks very robotic, right? Hello, how are you? What would you like to eat today? You know, it's crazy, and but we have to do what we have to do, right?
Maybe it's a warning, what we're gonna face in the future.
Yeah, you know what? I do. Would you agree or disagree with me? I think there will be a second wave.
Yeah, I agree with you. I do. I think there will be a second wave as well. But we have to learn from this period and to improve our mindset, you know, to be able to, as I think we have learned so many things from this period and we have been still learning it. For example, we have been washing more our hands, we have been wearing face
Yeah.
masks, and it helps us a lot in a certain extent. I think from now on, we ever, what's the word? We're gonna have to do that things all the
Oh,
time, you
it's
know,
kind of like the
forever.
new norm. The new
I
norm.
think it'll be the new norm because I know they are developing a vaccine, but people, especially the government, will be concerned about other diseases. So,
Well, you know
yeah.
what? I don't want to scare you, Ricardo. Okay, Richard. But
Richard.
I heard that right now in China they're detecting the swine flu.
Yes, I've heard that
What
too.
the heck?
Oh my gosh.
I was
Yeah.
like, what? Well, we haven't gone over the COVID. We haven't like conquered the COVID yet. And so I was watching and an expert asked another expert, they said, can you have one pandemic on top of another?
Really?
Yeah, I was like, oh my God. I was like, please, please, please just die out the swine flu. Please just die out. Yeah.
Thank you
Go
so
for it,
much for this
Richard.
incredible
We'll talk
class. I
soon.
like a lot of this class. Have a
You
great day
too,
and great
Richard.
work,
Take
okay?
care.
You have a good one. Take care. Bye.